Hello guys, welcome to W3H video. In today's video, we will look into color wrapper tool by which you can create any look. So let's get started. Any look consists three things: its luminosity and its chroma, then texture. With color wrapper, you can handle chromaticity alone. Here, this is hue versus saturation, hue versus hue, all combined in one tool. For selecting point, you can select the point, click on this icon. By default it is selected. Click on icon, you can select it. And what you are selecting, you can see by holding down option or alt key, you can check what you are selecting with that point. So let's start with these tools. This tool is a selection tool. You can select the point which one you adjust. This is selection tool by which you can draw to the point which you want to select. And third, this is a pinpoint. You can lock that point by this tool. If you moved anything, that point will not move. And afterward, this is a pull points. It's like when you selected this, all the nearby point will be attracted to that points, just like this. The last one, it's just opposite of that. It's repel all the nearby point. And this selection tool, if you selected one point, if you selected this point, it will increase selections fall off. It will increase more points. And this one is just opposite. And this one is whatever you're selecting, it will reverse that. And this one is once you selected the point, let's select with the drop point. We selected this point. You can lock that point with this tool. This is all locked. This point didn't lock. This is moving. And here, if you select the one point, this will select the whole line. And this one is the same. This will select the all hue of that saturation. And this is the select all point. And this is reset. And for selecting, you can even choose here when you turn on auto lock. If we are selecting one point, then look, if we want to move this point, it is locked. One below point and above point, it's locked. And if you select four point, it will do the same. It will lock four below and four up points. And afterward, this, if you select this point, you can change the hue of that point, saturation of the one point in one tool, and luma of that hue. So if you want move your hue evenly, then hold shift before selecting the point. Then if you increase decrease, it will decrease your saturation evenly. And if you move the point and click shift, then it will change the hue evenly while fixing your saturation level. So how we can use that? So bottom section, you are saying 12 by 12 grid. It's a start from 6, it's not that useful. It's 8, it's okay. It's 12 point, this is ideal spot. And 16 is okay. And 24 into 24, it's overkill. My recommendation is work in either 12 or 16, not in 8. So let's select 12 for now. For any grading, you have to first consider the skin tone. So as we can see here, at this axis our skin is, so we will select the point, select the draw selection tool, and just draw over the all the point where the skin is belonging. And then we will click on this icon to lock it. Once if we locked it, select the selection point, and we can move all the point. If you want your blue towards sham, you can move that way. By this easily manipulate, you can sky color sky. If you want your green on yellow side, you can on yellow side. If you want your green to sham side, you can move that way. And this way you can create any kind of look. You are fixing, you are not changing skin tone and manipulating other hue and saturation. If you want to add redness to your skin, select on auto click, select 5 point and select the higher point, this point, control click on this point and hold shift and drag the point. just little bit. This way you can add redness to the skin. So this is the way you can use this hue versus saturation color wrapper. And in, if you open this tab, this is a hue versus luminance. You can decrease the luminance of the certain color. For example, let's change to 12 by 12. We can select this point and we can change this, select all the point, and we can decrease the luminance all over. We can increase the luminance if we want, and we even can shift toward a blue to yellow side. Just lock this point, select, lock this, and we can manipulate green's luminance this way. This way you can add density to the green grass or something, trees, leaf. So, and this is your hue angle. You can change the plane of the angle. For example, here green to magenta and blue to orange. But you, if you change the hue angle, it will change the, for example, now it's red and cyan, it's changing its panel. And once you are seeing grid 1 and grid 2, grid 1 is associated with this one, grid 2 is associated with these two. So these are the tool color wrapper. You, it's have multiple possibility. You can do any kind of color grading. Once you know the tool, how you can use it, you can create any kind of look. Hope I considered all the point for the color wrapper. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video. Hope you like it.